So today we have covered about the CSV transformation. These are the topics we have covered, and property file concept also. That yesterday was stuck up, right? Then while doing the CSV transformation, we are facing some issue. I did some mistake only because we are passing the CSV transformation in the header. It was select by default application CSV only, but yesterday it was select other format only, like something I'll show you. If I'm not selecting, it will take some other format only. So that is the reason it got error out. Just go and verify that header level. So if you are taking this one simple text format, automatically it will coming as a application CSV only. But yesterday it was selecting like this is the format it was selected. So that is the reason we are facing an issue. So application CSV is the content type, means we are passing the text format here, like in the body. Example, if we say select the JSON, means application JSON, automatically system is going to taking, but yesterday it was selected as the wrong radio button. So that is the reason we are facing an issue. Please remember this one also. I didn't notice yesterday, so that is the reason got error out. So application CSV, automatically system will take only. So if not, just you can modify like application slash CSV. Then content type is CSV format, means system, we are saying that this is the CSV format only, so that mail will receive the format as a CSV and do the transformation, what are the format you want. Okay, application CSV only. Then what are the content you want, you can send it. Then the same flow, if you run the flow, then you will get the output as a JSON format. Because the only thing is, this is the format which you are passing from the postman. Or else if you're passing from the read file, anyway, we are giving the name of the file. That is sample.csv or example.csv, whatever the name you want. That we are passing the CSV format only. The system will understand, but we are passing the postman. This is the text only, right? So you can go to the header part and content type. This is the syntax only, content type, application CSV. You can pass it here. If you're passing the file from postman, then you can verify in the header level what format we are passing. As expected, then fine. Sometimes it will take. Now we are taking the this one, right, text format only. So it will be application text only, but we are passing CSV format. So system is not supporting. So that is the reason it got error out. Just go back and modify application CSV slash CSV. Then you can send a file. You will get the output only. Now deploy. I'm going to converting as a JSON format. Okay, so what is the type of the file? CSV transformation. Then you can send your file, you'll get the output. This is the output. The same. Now before we discuss the JSON to CSV, XML to CSV as well. And now we're going to CSV as input and converting as a JSON format. Now the same, if you want to converting as XML, XML root element is mandatory. You can pass the root element as well. Persons, without root we cannot generate converting as a XML format. Persons log bracket, then put it here. This is the bracket, and it comes under this one in the middle of the flow that we already discussed. Okay, we can modify as XML just to restart. And it is going to be converting as XML format. Now it includes a multiple persons only, single root element. If you want to apply for the subroot, then go here, just subroot here. Person, colon, bracket, just remove this bracket, keep it in the down. Okay, now restart, you get the output. This is the subroot. So this is the only changes because of header, application CSV, then you get the format. If you want, you can pass the CSV file from postman. Just you can modify this one, content type, application CSV. So this is the transformation which we are discussing yesterday only. Now coming back to topics, what are the regular topics now? Now this is how we are going to write the loop by using map operator. we are going to apply for the looping files. If you have a list of files, we will support the operator called map operator. Map operator behavior is key value pair combination. So that is the reason we are passing here key value pair combination. Means this is statically you are mentioning that, okay, go to here, means all the key values go here and index the some name you are defining here. So index based the system will store, and if you want to retrieve the data by using this one, by calling this one, because it will store all the key combination. So which key you want in the payload 01, it will hold all the list of keys and values. But so which key you want, then you can mention here only payload 01 dot, because in the payload 01 I have a list of elements. Which element you want? Person ID value I want, last name value, first name, address, city. If you want, you can modify here also, like anything, whatever the name if you are putting here, just to select this is the same name, you can put it here only instead of payload 01. Means system will understand comma left side part is all the key combination will be storing, and it will store like a in memory, like local memory, index based only. This is nothing but a statically you are saying that you can store here only. There is a one more approach called dynamically. Dynamically means, example, remove this one. So example JSON if you take CSV JSON. Now how to write that dynamically? There is a mechanism called $DDD mechanism. Here dollar means value. $DDD means index. So how we are going to write it? Payload map and payload 01 comma index. Index of payload 01, or else if you want, you can mod whatever the name you want. Means this is saying that statically you are saying that, okay, you can go here only, you can go here only. But this is nothing but a statical mechanism. But dynamically mechanism means $DDD concept. $DDD means how loops are writing payload, map, flow packet, start and end. We are not defining anything here. Like this is the syntax usually we are following, right? Till now, this is syntax. Means this is nothing but a static. This is nothing but a dynamic. Dynamic means dollar means anything, either payload 01 or payload 02, payload 03, or keyword name or something, anything only. That is nothing but a dynamically. So this is nothing but a $DDD means index. So there are two ways we are going to write the loops only. One is this is the one, another approach is this is the one, $DDD concept. Now the same approach if you want to implement, example, payload, map, flow packet, start and end. Now example, same person ID, colon, dollar dot, person ID. Here dollar means anything. Dollar means anything. Like whatever the name you want, you can put it only. System will take as a dynamically, it will fetch the data. So static means now you are specifying something now. Dynamic means how we are going to retrieve the data with values by using as a dynamically means $DDD concept. Here dollar equal to value, $DDD equal to index only. So and then last name, the same loop mechanism. Last name, dollar dot, last name. First name, dollar dot, first name. Address. So there is no difference only. Only the difference that is static, this is dynamic. Now the flow, if we run the flow, you'll get the same output. There is no much difference. Then you can apply for the subroute as well. Then you apply for here only. So this is also one more approach to write the looping in the MuleSoft. $DDD. Okay. See subroute. Now if you want to apply for the index, I want to display the each. Now currently I'm applying for the root element. Instead of root, I want index only. Index means start with a zero. How we are going to apply? Now just remove this one. If you want, you can put it here also. $DDD. Now instead of root, it will display even key root, key index also. If you want, you can put it. Okay, see index only, or else I don't want here only, I want with element level, then you can apply here also. Index column you can add, because source system is not sending, but they are expecting index column in the target system. Index column double dollar. If you want, you can put it root element here. Persons. Remove the column here. You can restart. So this is nothing but a dollar double dollar concept. Okay. So index column is going to be added in the elements only. And one more thing. In the source system, they are sending the elements as a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elements. But target system is expecting extra columns only. Then you can add it here only. Manually, we need to add. Example, job. Something you can job, then we can find out how we are going to retrieve the these values. Because source system sending the 5 elements only, but target system is expecting six elements. Then this is the example. The key is the job only. Then we need to find out how we are going to retrieve. Example: sometimes we have communicate the third party system, get the data. We are going to append here also. So these are the requirements also frequently we are getting now. But source system saying sending only 5, but target system expecting more than 5 elements. But again, we are going to discuss it in 2. From where do I need to fetch the rest of the elements? Then they are going to suggest in between you can communicate with either file, what we discussed, the file palette, right? Then get the file palette and append the source system and file palette, merge the data and send to the target system. These are the requirements also which are getting frequently. Okay, others, if you want, you can add a new only hard coded things if you want. Something IT job or something. Okay. Now, each row it is going to be adding as an IT, this job. So, manually we are adding this one. See, like this. Or else, if you want, you can take one variable also. Take one variable instead of hard coding. Okay, profession. The value coming as a query parameters. Then, if you want, you can use this one. Attribute start query parameters. Attribute start query parameters, profession of name of profession or something. Now, because this is coming from dynamically, example. Now, the same variable, if you want to reuse it here, so where's dot profession. So, that we discussed last week classes only. So if you have defined a variable in the outside of the transformation, I'm going to reuse it in the inside of the data view. Now, while passing the data from Postman, again, we need to pass it this one as well. In the Postman, we are passing now query parameters. Example, business. So along with the file, we are also passing some parameters, input parameters. Now go and verify here. See business. It is going to happen with business. Now this is also dynamic approach. So create one variable, the variable value coming from the query parameters, the same query parameter variable value, I'm going to reuse it in your data view manual. So this is how this kind of requirements. So now just query parameters, and sometimes we are fetching from the third party systems also, that what how we are going to communicate the third party system by using the connector, related connector, and keep it in the before transform message. How we are going to added, right? The set variable. Like this, we are going to add one more connector and fetch the data and append source system data as well. The connector data, like this, we are going to merge and send to the target system. So these are the requirements also which are getting frequently. So there are two ways we are going to write the loops. One is static mechanism, one is dynamic mechanism. The dynamic always system will support only dollar double dollar only. So don't use the other symbols only. Dollar double dollar is the means of itself is provided only. So we should follow the dynamically if you want to retrieve or define in the data view. Dollar double dollar is the mechanism. By using double dollar, dollar double dollar, we can write the data view looping mechanism. Any doubt here? Okay. Now in the means of, there are two ways we are going to write the loopings. Okay. Sorry, three ways. One is still now we have covered the map operator. If the dollar double dollar, that is forgot about retrieve the values only. I'm talking about the operator point of view. Map operator, map object. Another one is plug. Okay. Normally there are multiple ways which you are using the looping in the other programming language, like file, for loop, do while do. These are the looping mechanism which are following other programming languages, other integration tools also. But when it comes to the MuleSoft, till now we have covered the map operator. So the purpose of map operator is, if you have a list of file and you want to apply for the looping mechanism, MuleSoft introduced the operator called map operator. There are two operators are available in the other not only map, there are two operators are available in the MuleSoft. What is the name called? Map object and plug. So map, what is the difference between map object plug means? By default, map return type is array. Map return type is array. And by default, map object return type is, map object return type is object. Okay. And plug, by default plug return type is array. Okay. Map by default return type, like, means if you are applying for the map operator here, the return type should be array only, like this, array only. Okay, the same scenario, if you want to apply for the map object, then we'll get the return type is object only. Object means this is one flower bucket start, one flower bucket end. This is nothing but in single array, we have a multiple objects like this I'm talking about. Multiple objects. Each object we are going to separate it with comma. Okay, that is nothing but object. And plug also return type is array. Inside array, there are multiple comma separated objects only. Okay, this is the default behavior. And when it comes to the map operator, here dollar means value. It's what we discussed before, right? So dollar means value. Normally, how we are going to return the without dynamically payload 01, right? Payload 01 nothing but value. Here, dynamically, if you are specifying, dollar means value. And double dollar means index. So how we are going to apply here index? The double dollar means index, so it is going to be returning the output index. Okay, the same, instead of map operator, if we are applying for the map object, here dollar means value. Here dollar means value, and double dollar means key. Key means it is going to be, instead of returning, if you are applying for the map object, and the say in the map object, if you are using the double dollar, what value it is going to be returning? Key it is going to be returning. Means key. This is the key value. Normally, this is nothing but a key. This is the key, this is the value. If you are using for the map object, in the map object, if you are using double dollar, then return as a key only, not in the index. Okay. And return and double dollar is key. When it comes to this one, plug, here dollar is value and double dollar is key. This is the only difference. Map by default array, dollar equal value, double dollar equal index. When it comes to the map object, return type is an object, dollar equal value, double dollar equal to key. Key means person ID or value, last name value. So this is nothing but a key only. So pluck means by default return type is array and dollar equal value double dollar key. So after seeing the output file, then we are going to choose the which operator is going to be supporting. Index with array, customer is expecting index with array, then go for the map operator. Key with object, then go for the map object. Key with array, then go for the pluck operator. Based upon the output file, we are going to choose the operators, map, map object, either map or map object, pluck. But most of the scenarios, we are going to use the map only. So map object, very rare cases, and pluck, when compared to the map, this is also very less only. But 70-80% we are using the map operator only. Because all the files we have a list, they are expecting an array format only. If they are expecting array with the key, then go for the pluck only. Sometimes they are expecting the key value combination only, then key, or else index based, then go for the map operator. So these are the three operators. By using these three operators, we are going to apply for the looping mechanism in the MuleSoft software. Okay, till now we are going to cover the map. Now the same map object I'm going to cover. The same way, there is a one document which I have prepared, example also. See, map return type is array, that's what we discussed. Map return type is array. And here double dollar equal to value, double dollar index only. The same map object, return by object, here double dollar equal key. So return type is array, return the double dollar key only. Even all the in the all the three dollar equal value only. Here double dollar only, difference only. Now I'm going to show you one example. So take one example. Anyway, I have an example which I have prepared already. That's the sample file example. Okay, pass the compose file. Post method, body, REW, XML. If you see, by default it is taking, but here CSV is not available, right? So that is the reason before I take the application text only. Okay. Now, this is a simple element. So if you go and verify, just same logic, take this one. Okay, what code I have written, I'm going to explain now. First, the input file is XML file, that is single object. Okay, now this is the root element. As you know, right, if you want to call the child elements, first we need to call the root element. So root element, the file is available in the payload only. So that is the reason I was selecting as payload.price and the map operator here. And if you want to apply for the root element of JSON, colon, here we are going to write the root element of JSON only. And XML file, root element, colon, flower packet. That is the XML behavior. Now I'm going to converting XML to JSON transformation. And this is the variable which we know, right? Local variable, how we are going to create it, where this is the key, this is the value. And the payload.price, map operator, this one. And the same what we discussed, if you want to apply for the dollar, double dollar, single quotes one. Here a dollar is the key and value means single dollar. I told you, right? Dollar equal to value, double dollar equal to index. Here dollar means what value it is going to be taking, right? In the input file, it is going to be taking as 990.53, 3.9.8, 9.99. This is the value, this is the key, this is the value. Here if the loop will repeat, every time it is taking, appending as dollar, first time loop will repeat, it will take the 9.99. Second time it will repeat 53, third time it will repeat 398.99. Like this, dollar is going to be repeating. Then second element, dollar dot multiplication, if you want to apply the multiplication, star is the multiplication. And the conversion rate is, this is the conversion rate. And equal 13.45. So every time loop will repeat 9.99 into 13.45. The multiplication value is going to be appending to local currency. This is the simple data we code which I have written here. Okay. Now the same file, if you want to run, and I will show you the output, the difference between all three. Okay. Application deploy, you can send a request. JSON only price listed or something. Data also fine, application XML only. Create create application XML. Dollar double dollar. You call the function for that. What it is for document is for. What it is error. Payload or prices only. I will think correct. Same thing, right? File is dollar double dollar conversation map output. Same behavior on application XML, header or content type application XML. Post body. But the text print argument is type of file list. One minute, please, sir. I don't know sometimes why it is getting error. Okay, don't want to waste time only. I will cover today evening. Unless I don't want to waste time. We'll cover, sorry, I will discuss today. This one I'm going to explain because I don't know, because what are the code which are written, that is correct one. I need to look into this. Okay. Sorry, I'm going to cover the evening classes only on this one. Okay. So other topic we are going to discuss now. So operators which I'm going to discuss, like ascending order, descending order, these are the list of operators available. I'm going to cover now. Okay, I'm going to slide. Okay, operators means there are couple of operators are available in the data view. So we are going to cover the couple of operators. If you want, I will share you the list of URL also where it is available, because more than 100 plus operators are available. That is very difficult to remember all the list of operators. Frequently, max to max, we are using the 15 to 20 operators. So whatever we are using the frequently, that I'm going to cover you. If you want to learn more, then I will share you the link. Then you can go through the list of operators which you are using apart from the other operators I'm talking about. Okay. Now, just you can take one sample file. This sample file, if you want, you can take. Sample. This is the XML file. If you want, you can take. Post the data. Post method, body, XML file. Okay, this is the XML file which I am using. Okay, and I'm going to apply for the operators. What are the operators which are using? Okay, I'm going to write the data wave code. Now, application JSON. Okay, now write the data wave code means. So payload dot root is available, right? Root persons, and the subroots are available. So each is the repeated, right? So that is the reason. Star person map operator, and if you want to use the dollar double dollar concept term. Now subroot person. Okay. Now the same way, what we are doing, person ID. Dollar dot person ID. Last name. Dollar dot last name. First name. So normally how we are going to writing the data we got till now. Now I am going to apply for the order by. Order by nothing but ascending order. How to apply the ascending order in the data view? Okay. Now ascending order, this is the nothing but 100, 0. I am going to apply for the ascending as a person ID. The predefined keyword is order by. Order by is the predefined keyword. Order small letter B by. Order by dollar dot. Where it is available person ID? Under person only. So person dot. Sorry. Person dot person ID. So ascending order, I'm going to apply on person ID column. So that is the reason person ID is available. Parent of person. First we need to define the person. Person data is available under dollar only. All the values are storing under dollar, right? So dollar dot person dot person ID. Now you can run the flow. Send a request. Okay, you want to let it pass. See 100 102 104. Now how, what is the file like? 100 104 102. Ascending order means 100 102 104. So what is the operator which is supported? Order by is the operator. By using order by, we are going to making as a ascending order. So skip null means yesterday we have discussed it, right? Skip null to remove the duplicate value. Sorry, to remove the null values. Skip null is a predefined keyword. By using skip null, we are going to remove the null values. And how to apply for the ascending order? Order by is the ascending order. And then if we want to apply for the descending order, example, there is no specific keyword of descending order. First, you can apply for the ascending order. On top of, you can apply for the descending order only. How to apply ascending order, right? Just this is the ascending order, right? Keep one bracket, ascending order. This is the syntax. So -1.0. So -1.0 means this is the predefined syntax which is supported by MuleSoft only. First, normally other operators, other technologies, ascending and descending, there are different operators are available. But in the data view, there is no specific keyword of the descending order. First, you can apply for the ascending. On top of, you can apply for the descending order only. So ascending order on top apply means keep the one bracket at runtime, and this condition is going to be executed -1.0, so that is going to be converting as a descending order. Now you can send a file. Still not running. One Two only. Again, restart. Sometimes it will take automatically restart. Successful. We'll try now if it is working or not to redeploy. See, now 104, 102, 100 only. So this is the syntax. First, you can apply for the ascending order, keep the bracket, and -1 to 0 only. Actually, in the 3.9 dot dot 0. The 3.9 version dot dot only, but latest version 4, right? They remove the dot dot, keep it like this only, -1 to 0 only. So there is no specific keyword of the descending order. First, you can apply for the ascending order. On top of, you can apply for the descending order. What is the syntax? Is bracket -1 to 0 only. So that is going to be converting as a descending order. Now you can see the 104, 102, 100 only. So this is how we are going to apply for the ascending order and descending order in the MuleSoft. Okay, now if you want to append two keys like plus plus means concatenate. Oh, what is the syntax? Is remove this one. So concat means adding the two keys, key values. Okay, now plus plus dollar dot example last name, comma, if you want to comment the line, this is the comment the line. This is the comment the line only. Okay, forward slash. Just restart. Think deploy. Okay, we'll see. See 100 Suman, 100 Suman, 100 Suman. This is the file. 100 Suman. Because I'm going to add in the first name and last name, it is going to be commented same. And if you want to maintain the space also, okay, if you want to maintain the space also, okay. And this is how we are going to add in the two key values, that is concatenate. How to concatenate means plus plus is the keyword, plus plus is the keyword. Normally, concat also keyword is available in other languages only, but in MuleSoft, if you want to add the two things only, plus plus is the keyword, that is nothing but concatenate. Okay, then again one more operator call. Sorry, last thing. Okay, if you have a duplicate values, okay, null values, skip null, and duplicate value means distinct by, small letter distinct, distinct by. So duplicate values, dollar dot persons dot person ID. So I want to remove the duplicate values. Example, there are 200, sir. Person ID, I'm going to apply for duplicate values on person ID only. Person ID is available, person ID 100. So this is the duplicate only. Then if you want to remove the duplicate values, send a request by using distinct by. We are going to remove the duplicate values. Now 100 I 102. So to remove the duplicate values, distinct by. If you want to apply for the ascending order, order by. There is no descending order. What the keyword means? First you can apply for the ascending order. On top of you can apply for the descending order. What the keyword means? Minus 1, 2, so 0 only. So that it's going to converting as a descending order. And concatenate means appending two strings. And distinct means nothing but a duplicate values. Now other keyword is group by. Group by means if you have a combination of persons, I want one set of this combination of persons, make it as a one group, other than one group only. Now 100 is two objects are available. Okay, I want to make it as a 100 is a one group, 102 is another group. Then go for the group by is the operator. If you send a request, see 100, 102. So group is a group of persons, combination which is available. On which combination I'm going to verify? Person ID only. Person ID combination, two are available. So I want to make it as a single group. So this is the one group, 100, 102. So what is the predefined keyword is? Group by. These are the data view operators. Okay. Now filter. Filter means I want only this specific person information. I don't want to send to the other information to the target system. Example, here double equal, single quotes, you can pass 100. So only it is going to be filtering like employee ID as 100 only. Just send a request, you'll get the only 100. Now you are going to hard code it here as 100 and you want to make it as a dynamically also. There are two ways what we discussed before. Keep one variable, example number, and you can pass as 100 only, example. And if you want to make it as a query parameter also, instead of hard coded here also, then you can take here instead of this one, vats dot number. This is one approach. Okay, just to restart.
So Shashank, can you combine distinct also here?
Which one? Distinct and duplicate, you mean to say, right? Distinct and
yeah,
filter.
Yeah, I mean like you just added filter, right? So can we add distinct along with it?
Along with distinct means you're going to remove the distinct duplicate only, then filter and
duplicate. Correct.
No, distinct means remove the duplicate values, send to the other than values. But filter means you are applying when the only target is next to filter move. How we are going to send a distinct and filter?
No, you are right. Like what I'm saying is like you filter, you are setting the filter just to make sure that you just get the value related to that particular filter values, right? So as you see, in the output we get the same values twice, right? That's duplicate.
Duplicate on, yes.
So can we add distinct so that we get only one value which is distinct, right?
Yes, only one
I mean,
value only.
in common, can any other reference value can be added here? Like variables can be added here along with filter or such.
No, filter is the only value we are going to filter in the data. That is the
Okay,
big
so you
difference.
cannot add any other reference along
No,
with
you
this
mean it's a
like
combination.
I just need to know if we can combine two different
Yes,
references.
you can add it. Combinations you can add it. That is not a problem. By want to
Okay.
duplicate and set it, then you can do that. Is what if you want you can apply. You mean it's a
Okay.
combination, right? You
Yes,
mean
yes.
a combination, right? Yeah, we can apply for the
Correct, correct.
combination also. Combination
Okay.
equals apply.
Okay.
Okay, now person ID equal, because that is a double equal, you should maintain here only. Double equal to only. Though before I was adding as a hard coded. There are multiple ways we are going to fetching as a dynamically. This is one approach, adding the one variable outside and reuse it here only. This is one approach because here also it was hard coded. And the same if you want to apply for the header level also. Variable create one variable, example number, you can take number. The same variable, the outside variable, you can keep it here only. Dash dot number. Same number you can reuse it here. The only difference is this is a header part. If you define here, you can reuse it in multiple places of in your data view code. But if you are applying for the single element, this is only applicable for single element only. There are multiple ways. This is also if you want you can follow. This is also can, if you want you can follow. That is based upon your comfortable. You can choose either of this one only. The only difference is this is the header part. This is the body part. If you apply for the body, only eligible for single element only. If you apply for the header part, we can reuse this number if you want. Here also you can apply instead of dollar. Is one to another approach. And here also hard coded. Instead of hard coding query parameters which you want to fetch, then control space bar attributes dot query parameters dot query parameters. Then what are the key you want? You can take it number of value something anything. But number of value is the key only that is coming from the postman. Okay, this number of value while sending the file, you can pass it from here. Params. Now, what are the number you want? You can pass it from the source stuff. So it is going to be filtering only. So there are multiple ways which we are going to pass it here only. Or else instead of query parameters passing here. Unnecessarily, why I am going to create the variable? Do I need to pass the query parameter? Yes, we can pass it here also. Attributes dot query parameters also you can pass it here. Attributes dot query parameters. Query parameters you can pass it here. Name, number of value. So unnecessarily, if it is required, you can create the variable. If it is not required, the whatever the variable value which you are defined here only, right? The same mechanism which you are going to define here only. But don't use the ML expression like hash bracket and attributes in the data view. Only it is going to be allowing, hash bracket don't use that. Only attributes dot query params only we are going to use it only. But normally this is the syntax which you are following. But in the data view, system can't support hash bracket only. Even if you are consuming the variable also, that's that only. Normally, if you are defining the variable and if you want to consume the variable, what how we are going to consuming in any other palette other than data view code I'm talking about. Hash bracket, that's dot something. Okay, number. So this is how we are consuming normally. Means other than data view. If you want to consume some other palettes, this is the syntax which you are following. But in the data view code, hash bracket it won't support. Just whatever the content which you are going to writing, right? same content we are going to keep it here only. So this is how multiple ways we are going to consuming the data and dynamically also. So this is also attributes are query parameters and key. The same number of value you can pass it from here. And the example, if you pass the 100 is going to open it here and number is coming from here also. Or else the same syntax, if you want, you can use it here also. Again, I don't want to global variable. I want to retrieve the same query parameter value. I want to only use it in the element level also. We can use this here also. We can use attribute star query parameters, attribute star query parameters. This is the syntax we can use it. And what is the key you want? You can use it also. This is also one approach if you want, you can follow. So normally people are using the globally so that we can reuse it only. So unnecessarily we are going to write the key syntax. This is sometimes, this is the 10 lines only. Okay, now sometimes you are getting 100 lines of code. So if you're keeping here only, the data we could look like a very big only. So all the reusable component things, they are going to define the variable level so that we can reuse it only. That is up to your wish, which approach you want. Because these are the approach which is supported based upon your comfortable, which one you want, you can choose it only. Okay, then here normally condition based if you want to verify other things, when otherwise condition if else only, but in Mule's data we code in Mule 3.9 when otherwise is available, if else is not available. In Mule 4 only if else is available. Okay, in Mule 3 condition based I'm checking. Okay, condition based checking normally other programming lines, when otherwise, when condition and take something now, example, otherwise take something. Okay, this is a when otherwise, or else if else only, if condition take this one. Okay, else take something, right? This is if else condition, this is when otherwise condition. But when otherwise condition is going to be available, it's available Mule 3.9 version. Mule 3.9, there is no if else condition. And Mule 4, it is available. Sorry. Available in only 4. Now we are learning the version called 4.x version. In 3.9, data view version is 1.0. Version is 1.0. In Mule 4, data view version is 2.0. 2.0. See, this is the 2.0 version. So only in 2.0 if else condition is available. Don't get confused. In 3.9 when otherwise condition is available. So even the rest of the operator is common. The condition based they are going to change. When otherwise condition only available in the 3.9 version, and if else condition is only available in the 4.x version, that is nothing but a 2.0 data view version. Now how we are going to apply for the if else condition? This mechanism. And if you want commented, commented one. If you don't want commented, I remove this one as well. Okay. I think something is missing. Just remove this one as well. So remove this one. If condition based, I'm going to write it now. So what is the file here? So this is the file, right? Payload.persons. Star person. And pop like that. If you have any data, we can take it. Okay. How to write the condition, right? If bracket last name, example, if we are expecting double equal to, we should maintain here, example Kiran or something, single quotes Kiran, then close the bracket and open syntax single. Yes, this is Kiran. Okay, now expand this one. This is the condition based I'm talking about. Else this is not Kiran. Okay, single quotes and comma. Okay, please remember there is no whenever condition 2.0x 2.0 version, only if else only. If dollar dot last name double equal to only, you should maintain double equal. Single equals just won't support in the data view. Everything, if you want to write any condition equal based, if you want to verify, double equal to dollar dot last name equal Kiran, then it will take the S, this is Kiran. If you are passing S input name, last name equal, if it's run test, so system is sending dollar dot last name equal to Kiran, then it will take yes, this is the Kiran is going to happen to last name only. If not, then this is not Kiran, it is going to happen to last name now. So this is how we are going to write the if else condition in data view. Okay. See, this is not Kiran because in last time I'm not passing any Kiran only. So that is how Suman or Suman something we are passing, right? Sorry. So that is the reason condition fail and it returning as a this is not Kiran. Okay, any doubt here? And upper also it is going to be applied. Upper characters. So upper means UPPR. Upper bracket. Because only capital letter they are expecting, then keyword is upper only. So all the elements is going to be converting as a capital letters. So I'll apply for a key. Okay. Sorry. I apply for the number only. Sorry. Just you can apply for apply. Lower also available, same lower only. You want to apply for the lower? Lower. Yeah, lower. Then it is going to convert example. What is the first name? First name, if you have Hanuma. Hanuman, it's going to convert as lower. So upper and lower also available, and the first character also, if you want to apply for the only first character apply also, single rise, floor rise, that is also operators which are available. I'm going to cover the next class only. So there are plenty of operators are available if you want to go through the operators also, because that is very difficult to remember all the operators syntax and everything only. Just frequently we are using, there are a couple of operators that we are going to remember. If you want to learn data view operators in 4.0, don't look for the 3.9. Now we are going to learning the 4.x version. Just click on this one. There are plenty of operators is available. So these are the operator section. Go to the core operators. These are the operators only. And each operator is very difficult to remember only. What are the operators which are using frequently? That we are going to remember. If on top of that, if you want to practice, you can practice only. So if you click on this one example, anything whatever the plug which you are discussing is available. Just they are given the some theoretical point of view and some example also how we are going to returning also. And this is the source code, this is the output code. So whatever the operator you want, you can select it and go through the document, and they are given the some example how to apply syntax also, what is the return type also, you will get the output only. So this is how we are going to practice the operators only. The transformation point of the same thing only. So on each element, sometimes they are giving the mechanism. I want this element like this, this element like this. Then you can go to in the data view operator section, which operator is going to be supported. Just to verify the syntax, you can apply in your project. Okay. Now I'm going to cover the some other operators as well. But on top of, if you want learn, this is the documentation is available. Go through the document and you can apply for yourself. And also that is not only this one, still more is available. The multi-part operators and string operators. This is the camelize, characterize. See how many operators. This is more than 100 plus operators are available. So that is very difficult to remember. Based upon the requirement, even people are also there keep on maintain the link only, open the document, and based upon requirement then go through the operator name which is available, how to apply the syntax, then we can apply in the data report. Okay, at least so if you attend for interview, they are asking for the what are the list of operators which you are using in your data view. They are not asking for the can you figure out the list of operators which is available in the data view. What are the operators which you are using till now? Can you please let me know? Then other if they are sometimes they are asking do you know this operator? Sorry, I never come across as of now because these are the operators which are frequent which you are using. Then that is very difficult to remember all the operators. So if you want, you can go through this operator section. So which is one important that I'm going to cover frequently, I'm talking, which is not any important, frequently people are using, that I'm going to cover. The rest, if you want, you can go through the document. Okay, any doubt? Okay, I'm closing now. We'll meet tomorrow, today, and the one which you're missing, right, map object, I'm going to cover today class only. Any doubt apart from this one, or else do you have any doubt till now, whatever the class which we have discussed, you can let me know. If you have any doubt, I can clarify. Okay, if not, I'm closing now. We'll meet today, okay, evening. Okay, see you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.